Okay, ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen and ladies and gents. It's 11:06 in the evening, Tuesday, December, or excuse me, January 24th. And I just want to take the time, I'm going to turn up the volume in my ear just a little bit. I just want to take the time to express something to all us people. And that expression is this. Not that, that's not the expression. We're gonna let Teddy Pendergrass and them play in the background. Bring Teddy down just a little bit. We're gonna get this volume thing taken care of. He's gonna play just for a moment for this video. We got two videos to do. I'm going to be doing a video after this by the publisher. We're gonna be introducing Eon. As a matter of fact, it's actually entitled The Introduction of Eon. And I think some of you who appreciate the transformation from Mr. Redress Wright, then Brett Jones, to Eon. I think you're gonna appreciate it. The truth be told, I've been more concerned about helping everybody else, and I haven't taken care of the name change, and I'm supposed to. I have all the paperwork that I need to do, and I haven't done it yet. And that's all me. That's not nobody else's fault. I finally just about caught up today. I got caught up so fast that I still have to do some things for Fran. And so what I did is I, with the help of the God that I serve, and I know some people don't get it. Why does he always mention? Well, first, if I didn't have faith, then the scriptures speak of a man being worse than a man without faith. There was nothing worse than a man without faith. A man without faith has no hope. He can't be trusted. A man without faith is not one that you can depend on. So be glad that I have faith. And be glad that that's what governs what I do. Be glad that I keep mentioning to you all that I am one of Jehovah's Witnesses. Because see, that right there is not a crutch. That's a protection for me and for you. Because I use the name of the Almighty. By doing that, I take him seriously. That if I use his name and I have intentions on causing you all problems, or taking from you, or robbing from you, or getting over on you, or stealing from you, then I have to pay and suffer the consequences. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't want to suffer the consequences of that. There are always consequences, cause and effect. I don't want to suffer the effect. See, my God happens to be my best friend. We got to know each other real well over the last 4 years. And continually, we're getting to know each other. So, that being said, this day, give you an update on Francis. That's the reason, particularly the reason why I'm doing this video. The documents that we've been putting in the court have been to correct some of the damage that's been done. Because she allowed other people to put documents into the record. And everybody's like, what are you doing for her? What, did you do this and did you do that? Look, ladies and gentlemen, you don't have to worry about, did I do this or do that for Francis? Because basically, I can only tell you from the 3 pages, almost 4, of a motion that I wrote for Francis today, 2 separate motions totaling almost 4 pages. I could not have done her any more greater justice. You see, Francis had court last week, and you all know I told you about Eric Alzenheimer, who was the so-called attorney, sitting up there setting her up, talking about me, trying to threaten me through her, and causing her problems. Well, he's gone, and there was a campaign on paper to get rid of him. I've done it many times, getting rid of an attorney. It's not easy in federal court because when you first try to get rid of an attorney, the first thing they tell you is no. Well, let's just say right after they said no, I kept saying that she was not going to waive time. Give her speedy trial. Why? Because this is the federal court. They can't give anybody a speedy trial. It is not possible. If everybody asked for a speedy trial, no case would ever go to trial. Because that's too many people and they don't have enough judges to bring cases to trial. And so I knew. They threatened her. On December 22nd, they claimed they had their initial arraignment when they originally had it in September. But because she said she didn't understand, they couldn't call it an arraignment, because you can't be prosecuted if you don't understand. So they ordered a psych evaluation. Psych evaluation said that she was competent. Okay, so now they had another hearing where the attorney speaks about entering a plea of not guilty on her behalf, i.e. saying that she understood, because she entering a plea, that means she understands what's going on. Now they can proceed. And that's what they did. And they told her, all right, we're going to have trial on January 23rd. A month and a day later, December 22nd, told her they're going to have trial on January 23rd. I told her, do not worry about that. There's going to be no trial January 23rd. It's not possible. I said, you haven't even gotten discovery yet. I said, the so-called motion hearing, they have not heard one single motion, has not ruled on a single motion. I said, you're not going to trial. I said, they threaten everybody with that. I said, if anybody knows that, that's me, because that's what I went through. And I saw other people going through that. So I know their game. Well, it still didn't stop her from being stressed. Ladies and gentlemen, your letters to Francis, your contributions to helping with her diet situation has been extremely helpful. And I want to thank you on her behalf, and she's asked me to thank you. Because of the threats that they have made toward me through her, she has stopped calling me directly. She doesn't want to be responsible, and I'm not going to let that be on her conscience if something were to happen to me as a result of my communicating with her. Okay. Well, we've been communicating, but we've been communicating through a proxy. And that's been going along okay. That person has been learning a lot as a result of the communication. Well, they had a motion hearing last week, and before they had the motion hearing, I put in a couple of motions, especially one against the attorney. On the 9th, they told her she couldn't get rid of the attorney. So on the 11th, I filed the motions, and on the 19th, they decided that they were going to have a motions hearing. At that hearing, the entire hearing was them talking about me and the presentments, because I don't call them motions. I think I may have called three of them motions, but most of them are titled presentments because of the UCC. But anyway, they are presentments. We're presenting things to the court, not motioning the court for anything. They decided to not really deny all of them, but he said he was denying things. Didn't give him permission to deny anything. We didn't give you that type of control. Ladies and gentlemen, that's okay. I told them, I told her husband, I told her family, it's okay. Let them say whatever they want. The fact is, it's already on the record. Let them claim they're denying this and denying that. It's okay. Sorry, that wasn't good enough. They couldn't handle it. Well, ladies and gentlemen, the motion I put together for today, they ordered, because I told her not to say anything at court, said you need to get rid of the attorney. The only way to get rid of the attorney is to make sure they understand that you're not going to cooperate. Ladies and gentlemen, you have to be willing to participate in your prosecution. The defendant and you, because you're not the defendant, have to be capable of assisting in their defense. Okay, so you need to participate. So she let them know she wasn't going to participate. And she's meeting with the judge. Now, many of you don't know federal court. You don't meet with the judge. You meet with the magistrate. But in January, she had two hearings in 1 month. In December, she had a hearing. That's three hearings. She hadn't had that many hearings since the first week where she told him she didn't understand. And steadily, they were threatening her. So as the judge is talking to her, she's not responding. She's exercising her right to remain silent. This judge ordered another psych evaluation. I know. Don't worry about it. Nothing we could do about it. He ordered it. Thank you, judge. Why did he order it? Because I kept insisting on her right to a speedy trial. Because I know they're not ready. Well, by ordering a psych eval, that puts a stop or a stay on the right to a speedy trial. The time stops. It's okay. But they know. The reason why he did it is because he also knows that I'd have to appeal his decision. And if I do an appeal, interocular appeal, during the course of a trial, the time stops. So he was putting me in a catch-22. It's a good thing I served the God that I served, because I put the matter before him. It took me 5 days of going to him asking for direction. And today, at the very last minute, as I'm putting it together, I realized, wait a minute, I can't do an appeal. Oh man, I can do a different appeal. An appeal unlike any other appeal that's ever been done before. Ladies and gentlemen, what I did is we put in a habeas corpus motion in 2015. They never responded to it. And then she had one of her friends put in another habeas corpus motion in October of last year. They never responded to it. Well, they have 60 days to respond to a habeas corpus motion in a criminal proceeding. Yes, I know that. I know these things. They never responded. Well, they had a motions hearing on the 19th of January, where they denied her motions. Not all of them, but just denied it. They had a motions hearing, which means they heard all of the motions, including the ones that are still sealed to this day. Yes, that's right. The original motions I put into the record and the issues I brought up are sealed from the public record. You can't find it on Pacer. Okay? They're blocked off from the public record. We have the original copies. But, ladies and gentlemen, because they had a motions hearing, all I had to do was say thank you. Because now I have the right to appeal. You know why? Because a habeas corpus is not a criminal proceeding. It is a civil matter. Even though it's brought in the same criminal case, it's handled civilly, which means it's a civil appeal, and she has a right to appeal it civilly. And so we're going to do our civil appeal. You feel me? You got me? By doing a civil appeal, it still goes before the circuit court, and it's an appeal, and we get to bring up the issue about the due process of the right to petition for writ of habeas corpus. So she gets her appeal, she gets their attention, and there's nothing they can do about it. And the psychologist, hey, we'll take care of them and him when the time comes, because she's asking for, since this is the second psych eval in the same matter, she's asking for a third party evaluator. She has every right to do so because it's the second evaluation. So she has the right, according to their so-called statute, to do a third party evaluator. So she's put in two motions, one for third party evaluator and one for a civil appeal, using their system against them. I just have to be careful, because what they're trying to do is they're trying to get at me through her, and I can't permit that or allow that. So I have to be careful and word the documents accordingly. What they have said is that they don't want me helping her. Fine. I'm not helping her. I'm giving her legal advice. She has already told them that she wants me as her counsel. She doesn't want me as her attorney. She just wants me as her counsel. She wants to be able to communicate with me and ask me, what do I think her course of action should be, after weighing everything? Okay. So, let's just say, my honest opinion, Fran, I believe she's going to be okay. I honestly do, and I wouldn't be saying if it wasn't true. And you haven't heard me say that before with the confidence that I say it tonight. So much that it is 11:20, and I've been up since 6 o'clock this morning, and I haven't had any rest because I've been working on motions all day and calling banks all day. Did you know I got Aquin saying for the second time that they are the lender and the servicer? Ladies and gentlemen, you can't be both the lender and the servicer. Not possible. They're two separate entities. Oh, and then they represent the investors. Excuse me? You represent the investors? You better show me a letter saying that you have the right to represent the investors. You need a power of attorney. You need some letter from the investors, not the investor. There's not just one investor. There are hundreds of investors, because remember, mortgages are placed in pools. It's called mortgage-backed securities. So it's not possible. All right, and finally, ladies and gentlemen, we'll keep this video at about 17 minutes. Just wanted to give some of you a heads up. When I tell you that there are too many of you, and I tell you that I can't do one-on-ones, too many of you are still calling asking for me to do one-on-ones. And I don't want to hurt your feelings, but I'm not taking on any more one-on-ones at all. I got too many, and I do more. And each of the people who I'm helping can tell you that I do more than what I promised them I would do. Okay? So what I can tell you is this. We will be bringing on the individuals at the SATCOM organization. We'll be having individuals doing the videos for SATCOM. That's why we haven't posted any videos on SATCOM. Why? Because I can't be the voice of Eon, the publisher, and SATCOM. It is not possible. Okay? This is not about me. I'm not running anything. As a matter of fact, with SATCOM, I literally took a step down. So I am a junior commissioner, not a head dog commissioner. Why is that? Because of SITCOM. Didn't want to have two positions of authority in two different companies with extreme power. Because power corrupts, but absolute power corrupts absolutely. I fully am a believer in that. Okay, so since that is the case, I'm not running the show. So all of you who are emailing and specifically addressing me, you are not getting anywhere with those emails. So please stop. Okay, if you have a question and we don't get back with you within a week and a half, then email us again. But emailing me 5 and 6 and 7 times is, I'm gonna stop answering your emails. Okay, I don't have time for that. I don't have a life. Okay, and I need to have a life. All right, ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gents, at 17 minutes, I just wanted to bring you this update on Francis and the update as to what's been going on. Thank you for taking the time. Have a good day.